Nokia, once known as the most popular brand in the mobile industry, they dominate the phone industry for over a decade, but then they lost it all, pushing them on the verge of bankruptcy. But since 2017, Nokia phones have started to come back in the market. Today, we will discuss what had happened and how they are coming back. Nokia is a Finnish company that increased Finland's GDP by more than 1.5%. Nokia accounted for almost a quarter of Finland's exports in 2003. In 2006, Nokia's revenue exceeded the state budget of Finland. Their 2100 series sold over 20 million devices worldwide. By 2007, Nokia had a 50% share of the mobile market. So, what happened to Nokia? Well, many think their downfall was due to poor management, where some believe they had tough competitors. Switching gears for a second, in 2007, Apple came out with its first ever iPhone, the iPhone 1. It was discontinued in 2008. One thing Apple learned from their first iPhone was that people love the touchscreen option. Also, their operating system was a success. At its core, Nokia was known for its hardware. In 2008, Nokia bought the Symbian, the operating system. They were still dominating the market ahead of competitors such as Windows Mobile OS and RIM's BlackBerry. This was a time for innovations. Phone technology was getting old and people were getting bored. First company to hit the markets with something new would take over the market, and Apple took advantage. With Apple's third iPhone release in 2009, they had upgraded to iPhone OS 3.0. This was a hit. Their market share doubled, reducing Nokia's share. Things were about to get super competitive for Nokia, with Google entering the market using their operating system Android. The launch of Google Nexus in 2010 helped Android become the best-selling OS worldwide. Nokia was still using Symbian. A study in June 2011 showed that over 39% of the mobile developers using Symbian had planned to switch to Android or iPhones. People preferred Android and iPhone OS because of two reasons. One, Symbian was not as popular in North America. And two, because Symbian was open source later, developers could not take full advantage of the Symbian as they did with Android and iPhone OS. Nokia's sales dropped drastically. In 2007, Nokia had a market capitalization of 110 billion euro. By May 2012, this had fallen down to 14.8 billion euro. In a way, Nokia was feeling pretty good with where they were, and that is when the iPhone and Android took them over. Nokia was now planning on filing for bankruptcy, but then another major player bought them out, Microsoft. In 2013, they announced that they would acquire Nokia's mobile device business for 5.4 billion euro. So, how is Nokia making a comeback? Well, the brand Nokia was always considered a reliable brand. In 2015, Nokia Technologies released the N1 tablet running with Android. With the new OS, they sold 20,000 units in the first 4 minutes, giving the tablet a rating of 9 out of 10. Then, in 2016, Microsoft announced that they would sell their phone business to a Finnish mobile phone company, HMD Global, for $350 million. The sale included design rights and the rights to use the Nokia brand on all types of electronic devices worldwide until 2024. For the first time since 2014, Nokia's phone was on sale in December 2016. Their first device, Nokia 150 Dual SIM with Android. Then in 2017 at the Mobile World Congress, HMD announced the relaunch of the iconic Nokia 3310. The phone was rated at 4.2. They also announced two new Android devices, Nokia 3 and Nokia 5. In 2017, the demand for Nokia's phone was 7 times higher than expected. HMD shipped millions of units of the 3, 5 and 6 across the world. 1.5 million Nokia smartphones were sold in the first half of 2017, making HMD the best-selling mobile phone vendor in Vietnam and Middle East. Then in quarter 2 of 2018, HMD sold 4.5 million smartphones, and in quarter 2 of 2019, they sold 4.8 million. Currently, the company is valued at 1 billion euro. Their brand has allowed them to quickly establish 50 locations around the world in the first 12 months of operating. Through a licensing agreement, they hold exclusive rights to the Nokia brand. Their manufacturer is someone we all are pretty familiar with, Foxconn. HMD has brought back Nokia brand for what they were known for, hardware. With new models made from a single block of 6000, 7000 series of aluminum and stainless steel, their phones are pretty strong and durable. Nokia Corporation may have gone for good, but the brand Nokia is still going strong. Nokia's story teaches us the importance of innovation and to keep up with the trends. But most importantly, to maintain a strong brand, as long as you have strong brand, loyal consumers may let go of your past mistakes and continue to do business with you. So keep an eye out for Nokia's devices in your neighborhood, just like you keep an eye out for our videos. Until next time, have a good one.